subscribe my channel. P. Sarala. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson. Welcome to another class of geology. So for talking and for walking and doing various other activities, what are the structures which are useful? Yes, muscles. So muscles are useful for all these things, especially for the movement. What is meant by movement? Movement is nothing but change in the position of a body parts is known as movement. So change in the position of hand or leg or the tongue or the finger is known as movement. If any movement which results in change of place or location, so change of place means from one place to another place or from one location to another location, if the movement which results in the change of location or place is known as locomotion. For locomotion, animals have different locomotory organs. So the organs which are useful for locomotion are known as locomotory organs. So locomotion is three types depending upon the locomotory organs: the amoeboid movement, ciliary movement and the muscular movement. So in amoeboid movement, locomotory organs are pseudopodia. In ciliary movement, locomotory organs are cilia. And in muscular movement, obviously muscles, skeletal muscles are the structures which are useful for muscular locomotion. So this is the skeletal muscle. So skeletal muscles are also known as striated muscles because the striations are present, dark and light bands are present. That's why these muscles are known as striated muscles. Striated muscles are known as skeletal muscles. Striated muscles are also known as skeletal muscles because these muscles are attached to the skeleton bones. That's why these muscles are known as skeletal muscles. These muscles are also known as voluntary muscles because these are under our will and wish. So the function is depend upon our will and wish. That's why these are known as voluntary muscles. So the muscles attached to the bone with the help of a tissue which is known as a connective tissue, which is known as tendon. So this is the tendon. So this is the connective tissue by which muscles are attached to the bones. So when we see the cross section of the muscle, it contains a number of bundles of muscle fibers which are known as fasciculi. The bundles of muscle fibers are known as fasciculi. So the muscle is surrounded by a connective tissue membrane which is known as epimysium. So this is the muscle which is attached to the bone with the help of a connective tissue which is known as tendon. This tendon is connected to the outer covering of the muscle which is known as epimysium. So epimysium is a collagenous connective tissue which covers the muscle. So this epimysium is useful to reduce the friction between the muscle and the bone and muscle with the other muscles. So each muscle contains a number of fasciculi, bundles of muscle fibers. Each bundle is known as fasciculus. So these are the number of bundles which are present in a muscle. So these are the fasciculi. So each fasciculus is covered by another connective tissue which is known as perimysium. Fasciculus is surrounded by a connective tissue which is known as perimysium. Each fasciculus, this is the fasciculus which contains a number of muscle filaments. So these are the muscle filaments. So these muscle filaments are covered by another connective tissue which is known as endomysium. This is the endomysium. So that muscle fiber consists of numerous myofibrils or myofilaments. Myofilaments. So each myofilament consists of number of actin and myosin filaments. If the muscle is very active, then the number of myofibrils will be more. Example, the muscles of the thigh region are contains numerous myofibrils. The muscles of the fingers, consists of few myofilaments. So each muscle fiber contains striations. That's why this muscle is known as striated muscles. So this is the dark band and next the light band. So alternate dark and light bands are present. So the dark band is known as A band and the light band is known as I band. So the appearance of dark and light bands is due to the peculiar arrangement of actin and myosin filaments. So actin and myosin are the muscle proteins. So these are present alternately in a specific manner. So these are arranged. So these are the actin filaments and the red ones are the myosin filaments. These are present alternately so that the muscle appears banded. That's why it is known as striated muscle. So ultrastructure of myofilament, it consists of numerous myosin and actin filaments arranged alternately. Each myosin or the thick filament, myosin filament is also known as thick filament, is surrounded by 6 thin filaments or actin filaments. The green ones are the actin filaments. So black one is the myosin filament or the thick filament. It is surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 actin filaments. So this is the structure. So when we take the actin or the thin filament is surrounded by 3 myosin filaments. So this is very important. It is not appeared in 2D diagram. Okay. That's why I draw a diagram here. Myosin is surrounded by 6 actin filaments and each actin filament is surrounded by 3 myosin filaments. So muscle fiber is a syncytium, means it is multinucleated because it is formed by the union of many or mononucleated myoblast cells during the embryonic condition. So these are the nuclei. So it is a multinucleate structure. Each myofibril or myofilament consists of dark and light bands. So this is the light band, which is also known as I band or isotropic band, and the red one. So this is the dark band which contain myosin filaments. That's why it is appears because myosin filaments are thick. That's why it appears as a dark. So it is known as A band and or an isotropic band. So these two bands are alternately arranged. So I band contains thin filaments or actin filaments. So actin contains 3 types of protein molecules. Actin, tropomyosin and troponin are present in the I band. So in the middle of the I band, a line is present which is known as a Z line. So why the name Z line? Because this line appears as a Z, alphabet Z. That's why this line is known as Z line or Cross-Hayes membrane or the Dobie's line. Other names for the Z line are Cross-Hayes membrane and the Dobie's line. So actin filaments are attached to this Z line. So this is the I band. So next to I band is a band. A band contains myosin filaments. So the sides of the A band, so the edges of the A band. So this is the A band. The edges of the A band, myosin actin filaments are also present. That's why the edges of A band are more darker than the middle part of the A band. So this is the middle part which contains only the myosin filament. So the edges contains myosin and actin filaments. That's why it is more darker than the middle portion. So the middle portion which contains only the myosin filaments is known as H zone. So this is the H zone. From here to here, this is the H zone. So the middle of the A band contains M blind. So these are the cytoskeletal structures which attach to all the myosin filaments and keep them in their position. So this is the M blind. So next, coming to from successive Z lines, two Z lines, successive two Z lines. So this is one Z line and this is another Z line. So the space or the bands which are present between the successive Z lines is known as sarcomere. So this is the region, sarcomere. So this is sarcomere is known as structural and functional unit of contraction. So actually this sarcomere from one Z line to next Z line is a sarcomere. So here the contraction occurs. So this is the basic unit of contraction. So each sarcomere contains one complete A band. So this is complete A band. On either side of the A band, half of the I band is present. So here half and here another half is present. So one complete A band and two half I bands on either side of the A band is forms the sarcomere. So this sarcomere is useful for the contraction. So this myofiber or the muscle cell contains cytoplasm which is known as sarcoplasm. So the plasma membrane of the muscle fiber is known as sarcolemma. So the cytoplasm is known as sarcoplasm. In the sarcoplasm, numerous mitochondria are present. Sarcoplasm also contains endoplasmic reticulum which is known as sarcoplasmic reticulum. This sarcoplasmic reticulum contains cisternae which are the storehouses of calcium ions. Calcium ions are very crucial for contraction. So we will learn about muscle proteins in the next class.